I don't remember that thing from last
time.
That's
new. Didn't have that last
year. I think that's great. Did we just talk really loud last time?
No, the microphone on this is okay. It's just you can kind of pick up the hum of the camera motor. This does not. It's just a cleaner sound.
Do I need to do this?
No. It's fine. It'll pick you. Just talk normally.
I don't know what that is.
Yeah.
That's true, actually. Talk normally.
Okay.
Hi, everybody.
Hi, camera.
Exactly.
I have lipstick on my hair.
Okay. See. You should probably scoot over just a bit because your shoulder's off frame. Yeah, that's good. Yes, we are exactly the same height.
Give or take, what, 6 inches?
Yeah, she has better posture. If I sit up straight, I'm almost off camera, so. Okay.
Plus, my hair is tall.
How you doing, Ma? Good, good.
Tall hair.
Tall hair. Yeah.
Mm. All right.
Are you filming and just being
Yes.
No, we're just
asking. It is filming.
It's filming. We're good. He edits.
He's just going to cut it out.
Not really.
Probably, no. Because otherwise people, what is this shit? And just click
on it. Click mom in the background.
My retention statistics look like this.
What is this? That's cool that you can do that. You have retention. Okay.
Yeah, I have all kinds of stats and demographics. And
what is this? What is that? Is that just sticking out from somewhere? Weird?
Yeah, it's from the back.
Okay, anyways.
Yeah, 10% of my audience is female. On the one where I was shirtless, it went up to 11%.
Well done.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
So.
Tell them why we're here, Andy.
Hello, Internet.
Hello, Internet.
Andrew here, along with my sister, Kelly. She spells her name.
Weird.
Like this.
Oh, are you going to put something there now?
Yeah, later I'm going to put a subtitle there. Otherwise, it would be really weird if I just gestured right here and there's nothing.
Oh, my.
People would be like,
I can't see it. It doesn't exist.
Like what? Oh, crap. Do I have to turn on the subtitles or something like that? Wait. Stop. I'm behind. We're not restarting. We're going straight from here.
You should never, ever put anything there.
Yep, nothing's there. How does she spell her name? I must know.
Never put anything there. Okay.
Is there a silent G?
In fact, there is. Let's talk about other things that we don't enjoy.
Yes, the subject of today's video, if you didn't look at the title, and I don't know who all does that, maybe I'll name it something obscure and symbolic. No, but it's probably going to be something weird like how to pet your peeves. So, we're going to discuss pets that peeve us.
Just to name a few.
Okay. So, there are things in this world that drive us nuts. Pet peeves, if you will. And you will, if you speak English. So, Kelly.
Yes?
What is one of your pet peeves?
Okay.
And why does it peeve you so?
Cupcakes. Oh my. Let's talk.
I thought this was going to be good, but cupcakes, please. Please, enlighten us as to why cupcakes peeve you so.
Let's talk about cupcakes. They are my favorite food. I love cupcakes. They are.
Mm.
I love them. However, the cupcake delivery system is completely out of hand. You get a flat of cupcakes, yes?
Okay.
At the grocery or wherever. And you go into class or you go, I say class because I bought some for a friend a couple nights ago. Or a party or wherever. And you can't get to your cupcake want, right? You go in and it's like, you're like, oh, have a cupcake. And you're like, I can't go in because you inevitably will get frosting all over and it tips to the side. You can't, there's no good way to get a cupcake.
Oh, so out of its little cupcake holding tray?
Yes.
Because its top is flush with the top of the
yes!
tray, so you're like digging your fingers
into
the cupcake.
So you're already like, you can't just be like, oh, thank you for the cupcake. There's no good way to get a cupcake. You just can't do it.
Someone should invent a utensil for removing cupcakes.
Or why don't they just like a little Easter basket, like it has a little top? So, like, a little handle that you can just, like, lift out your cupcake. And then it's just plastic, a little plastic ring, and then that can be thrown away and you can eat your cupcake. But every single person that takes a cupcake, and then they get their thumb, and then the cupcake next to it. And so that person's like, well, I want that cupcake because someone's thumb's already been in this cupcake.
Yeah. Have you tried, like, slapping the pan from the bottom and it pops up and you grab it? No? It probably wouldn't work. It'd be fun, though.
It's annoying as hell. It's the only good thing is that so many people say no that you go home with a lot of cupcakes. Ding.
You get to make fun. Here, have some cupcakes. Oh no, I couldn't. No, really.
No, they're really, impossible I to can't,
get
out of the pan.
I'd get them all over my thumb. I'd get my fingers in everyone else. Oh, that's a shame. I guess I'll just take them all home.
Fine.
My plan worked.
So since they're perfect for me, since I love cupcakes.
Yes. So
this is so annoying. They need to figure out how to. A better cupcake delivery system.
So, not the cupcake in and of itself.
Oh, there is nothing wrong with a cupcake. There is nothing wrong with a cupcake. Okay. There is only good with a cupcake.
Mm.
It's the delivery of the cupcake.
Right.
So freaking annoying.
And you can't just, flop that sucker over.
No! There's no, but even when you're, trying to be nice and you do the homemade cupcakes and you put them all on, on a circular thing, you still have, a plate of cupcakes that are all touching. And so their frosting is all commingling, and then you still go in and you still get the cupcake on.
Maybe the little paper wrapper that surrounds the cupcake, which you shouldn't eat. But I did when I was small, just to be silly. I'm like, no, it's part of the cupcake.
Paper.
I will eat it.
At least it wasn't a foil one.
No. If they made them longer, and then they splayed out around the cupcake, you could pick it up by the little sides of the paper and lift it out of the pan.
There are so many good, remedies.
Although I do like the, your almost Christmas hook idea. You just...
Yeah. just a little,
Like a little basket. A little
basket.
Wire basket thing. Just
pick it up.
Pick it up, take it with you.
Boom. Cupcake.
Mm-hmm.
Done.
Yeah. Improving the world. One cupcake delivery system at a time.
Right.
One of my pet peeves... is the microwave. Well, not so much the cupcake. It's not the microwave.
I was
going to
say, I think it's a fantastic invention, but hold on.
Actually, being a healthy eater. Hey, Bonnie.
Hey there.
There's a cat down here.
This is
Trust us. No, honestly, there's totally a cat down here. So we're not tying our shoes. Oh, okay. Had to prove it. So should I prove how you spell your name or should I just leave that on?
Kelly.
Subtitle.
Microwaves.
Wow. Microwaves. So
chiropractor, 74 yes. points.
This is my pet peeve. I'm petting my peeve. Hello, peeves.
And you didn't think you could do that on the internet? Oh, geez.
Sure.
Okay, we're good.
All right. So the microwave. This video is going to require judicious
Holy
editing.
Holy crap, we're going way off the handles here.
So, all right, microwaves, what really...
Frosts your cupcakes?
What frosts my cupcakes is when people use the microwave, and I'm going somewhere with this, is when people use the microwave, they put something in the microwave, they close the microwave, they put it for a minute or so, and they heat their food, and then they decide... it's ready now, and they open the microwave before it's done cooking. So there's 3 seconds left on the clock, and they take their food out, they close their microwave, and they just walk away, leaving the 3 seconds on the microwave. Hit clear or cancel! Oh, it drives me nuts when there's 3 seconds left on a microwave.
I do that.
And it's not like I really need to know what time it is. I mean, I have a phone. Thank you, work, for paying for my BlackBerry that I rarely ever use. there's a clock on the wall.
There's no clock on that wall.
There's a clock near where the microwave is. And in fact, in this house, the oven is right below the microwave. There's a clock right on it. But I was thinking more at work. If the microwave
Certainly.
Is here, there's a clock on the wall over there. I could totally see what time it was. But man, it drives me nuts. It's like, if you realize... that if you have it, that your food heating needs down to the split second, it's like, Oh, no. 1 minute is just too much. You know, that extra 3 seconds would overheat my burrito. You know, so if you know it takes 57 seconds exactly to heat your Hot Pocket, 5-7 start. Why did you put in a minute if you know? You know! That's too much time.
It's not about... It's impatience.
Of course, they're probably just hitting instant minute, which is shorter than going 5-7 start. But, you know, still, that's why it's a pet peeve, you see.
I do it because I don't like the ring.
You hate the beep, beep, beep thing of the microwave? Yeah.
And it's like,
is a forklift backing up? Your excuses, so your reasons, your justifications for doing so mean nothing to me because it still annoys the crap out of me. And I will stop whatever I am doing. You know, someone could be on fire and I could be running towards them with a pail of water and I will stop to hit clear on that microwave just to get rid of that damn 3 seconds left and put it back in the time where it should be.
Damn stupid.
So what's another pet peeve of yours?
Well, I'm going to irk some of your viewers now.
Oh, okay.
By saying the word, can't even do it with a straight face.
Mm.
Yes, ready? Moist.
Moist.
I can't stand people. Do you know about this phenomenon? The people who,
I understand
like,
the concept of moist.
Oh, ass. There are people in a significant amount who can't handle the word moist. I know these people.
Really?
Oh my golly. You should like Google this. You should look into this. There
turn safe search on before you Google moist.
Okay. There are many a people, like, they cannot handle, they're like, oh, it skeevies them out. And I'm like, get over yourself. People who, like, I work with these people. It's not like I go around all day going moist because not many things in my work environment
are moist. If I knew someone had a problem with that word, I totally would.
Sure.
And hey, Jerry.
We do. Like, we
moist.
Often are making cupcakes and they are quite moist.
Mm.
But just, it get a, like, find, like, it's a word.
And you'd know that if you could get them out of the pan.
This is true. This is so, you're missing out on a very moist cake.
Are you sure you don't want to go after this cupcake?
It's quite moist. But no, there is. You should really look. It's people. There was an article in.
So you're not bothered by the word. You're bothered by people who are bothered by the word.
Yes.
Okay.
You ingrates out there. Learn. There are great words. You know what a good word?
Mm.
Fjord.
Fjord.
We don't live in Norway, so we don't often get to use it.
Even Pinky from Pinky and the Brain knows that. Fjord!
A good word. You know what a thwart.
Thwart,
that's
good
a good word.
Word.
I try to use that daily.
And thwomp.
Not.
Which is not really a word. It's
in a
kind of
video game.
Yeah, the name of the little bricks with the faces.
I know.
That,
I know. I play video games. He's my brother after all. Crazy ass.
Yeah.
I'm adding. Taking them out systematically. This is number 3. Next!
Her hair's going to be totally down by
it's
the
it's going to be down. I have a bobby pin headache.
I'm going to have to enable slow motion when she does a thing.
Dude, that you came really down.
I must put my eye out on video. That would have guaranteed like 100,000 views.
Ratings.
Got to retitle it. Andrew puts his eye on the video.
You got to put your eye out.
Yeah, this is not my one of the pet peeves I had, but you know what? There are words in the English language that do just... I just don't like the sound of them, and I will go out of my way to not use them.
Mm-hmm.
One of them.
He's not going to tell you. That's so rude. And I don't watch his videos, so I'll never know.
I'm probably not going to put anything right here. I'm just going to keep doing this.
Well, now I look ugly. I'm just going to twirl it like a schoolgirl and put it behind my ear. La, la, la. I don't like the word no.
No.
It's mainly because it normally follows a question of something I want to do, and then they
I didn't like the word no when apparently I don't remember being 1 year old, but apparently when I was, Mom would say, "Andrew, no, no, don't stick the fork in the light socket."
That's not much different from today in you, though.
That's true. Hey, Andrew, we're going to church. Can I stay home? No. Get in the car. I want it. So, Yeah, I embarrassed all of them at church today.
I really want to know what this word was.
It's like, how do you spell her name?
I'm so excited and...
All right, second pet peeve of mine.
Oh, whoa. See, mine are all these tiny, yes, cute ones, and yours are really getting under skin.
Well, yeah. Well, that's the problem when you're me and you have two settings. You have pleasant nothingness and furious rage.
I'm talking about cupcakes, and you're like, you could hang the person who took
I will kill you!
You took your Hot Pocket out 3 seconds early!
I will submerge your face in a tub full of lye if you don't hit clear on the microwave. What's wrong with you? All
right, next.
Where was I? Number two?
Yeah, still.
Okay.
half hour later.
Let me set this up for you, because unless you happen to be a workmate of mine, you wouldn't know what I was talking about unless I gave it the proper context.
Oh, okay.
So at work, we have what was called the Honor Bar. Right. Not quite, no.
I'll pay for it later.
What? Yeah. That is what it was. We had a little wire basket of chips and cookies and Mrs. Fields chocolate chip cookies and sodas in the fridge. And you were on your honor to drop 50 cents. It was later changed to 75. because many people were not on their honor. You drop 75 cents, you grab a bag of chips. Cool. Or a soda or cookies or microwave bowl burrito or whatever it is, hit clear. So Honor Bar. So we had a change can for you to drop your change in. And we had, if you didn't have exact change on the day that you wanted some instant oatmeal or whatever, you could write out an IOU. And we had little pads of paper and pens and a little cup sitting there. You could take a pen, say, my name is Steve and I owe 75 cents, and you tack it on the board. Some people, after filling out their IOUs, would take their pens and not replace it in the cup where all the pens are. The repository for pens. The place from whence the pen originated. And they will put it in the coin jar. They don't go in there! They go in the cup with the other pens. You don't put it in the change can. If I will set up a security camera and I will find out who does it. And every time I went in there, I said, son of a... They go right here. It's not like on the other side of the room or anything. It's not totally inconvenient. You take it out of the pen holder. You fill the thing out. You put it back in the pen holder. You don't dump it in the change can. That's not where it goes.
You're not part of this video. No, I'm just
sorry.
It's all right. Mom. She's trying desperately to ignore us and read her entertainment magazine, but it's kind of hard. Tim's hiding in the other room going, I can't believe these kids. You know what doesn't bother me for some reason, though? The IOUs you're supposed to tack up on the pegboard. Some people would dump them in the change can instead of pinning them up on the board. For some reason, that didn't bother me.
Oh.
Because I can kind of see, it's like, this is my IOU.
This is my money.
This is
the
money.
Money.
It goes
the money.
In the change can. I can kind of see the logic here, but not the damn pen.
Because the pens can leak and make the chains all sticky. It's true.
I guess. But no, that, it's just the wrong place for the pens. The pens have their place, and that is not it. It's one of my pet peeves. But, too many people were not on their honor, so we don't have the honor bar anymore, so it's not something that bothers me anymore.
Aww.
Yeah.
Too many people just ate cookies and didn't pay for them.
Yeah.
That's sad when you can't just have a cookie when you want it.
Yeah, or, just we couldn't afford it because too many people just would forget about their IOUs. I mean, there are some people at boards up there, like, 20 bucks in IOUs, and it's like,
I mean, let us not be confused. Do you remember in high school when we used to sell the candy for the choir or whatnot? I mean, when you have a bag of candy and you're, how old are you in high school?
14, 18.
Something like that.
Or 25 in some people's case.
Okay. Sure. But, like, you know, you have
Hey, there was a teacher I really had a crush on, so I was deliberately failing, okay?
But, like, you have a bag of candy with you at all times, and you're like, I just have this Crunch Bar. No big deal. I got it
right on the eighth attempt. What?
And then all of a sudden at the end of the week when I had to turn in my candy and my money, I was like, well, shoot, I have $2 and no candy. How'd that happen?
What, Miss Shively? I only checked out 4 boxes of candy.
I ate
40? No, that's an extra zero. I don't think that was supposed to be there.
I'm not very good with my decimal places yet. Yeah, I'm only 16.
40? No, that's implied one decimal place, so that's 4.0. So these two bucks, that completely covers it.
Only good.
Today it's probably like $1.75.
Oh, Hannah. I'm sure it's something strange. Flipping Girl Scout cookies are like $3.75 a box.
Yeah.
They have to be $2.50.
More expensive, less cookies in the box, lower quality cookies.
I heard a noise.
Is it me complaining?
No, I can tune that one out.
Oh, all right.
I've learned.
Yeah.
Anyhow. Cars. Okay, so.
This is very therapeutic.
No, oh my Hannah, right? Except for the whole headache.
Actually, yeah. I think I'm going red in the face here.
Blush looks good on everybody. Here's another one.
Hey, hi, Jeremy.
This is another one.
Cats.
Ding.
See? this is worth, you know, like 50,000 views right here. Oh, kitty.
We have a kitty, kitty. Jeremy's like, I didn't brush my hair today. So, I don't know why I feel this way. I can't stand it. I'm really going to ostracize all your viewers. Every nice thing that they've said about me last year, they're going to be like, your sister is a...
I totally
not
going to
tell you what it is. No, he doesn't. I saw that. I don't like it when people back in the car spaces. Like when you're in a parking lot and you got to be like, there's a parking space. You pull into that. You pull. You don't go, ah. Like, you don't. That's dumb. However.
I know where this is going.
I love the pull-through. The pull-through is not a back-in. The pull-through is a special, special, amazing thing. Because you don't have to be a douche and back-in, but you still can be awesome and pull forward and leave. It's fantastic. I can't stand people who back-in. Like, I just think it's dumb. Like, just... I can't even describe the feelings and emotions that go into watching someone back into a car space. I think that you're cool and you're not. You're just not. You're not. But the pull-through is awesome. If you got a pull-through...
Well, she didn't want to say anything.
What just happened?
Mom said, you know...
You back
just,
in?
Just like she backed in at the
church this morning.
Church this morning.
Did you not remember?
You didn't back in church this morning.
She's,
you did?
She's blocked it out.
I totally blocked that out. Because I totally would have said something if I remembered. Dude.
No, I have
there, to. There goes your bar cookies. Out the window. Cats eat them.
Man. Now I have to subtitle all of Mom's dialogue because the microphone's probably not picking her up. If you're like, what? What? Did someone off camera reveal how to spell Kelly's name?
No, because they don't know.
No. If you missed how to spell my sister's name, rewind this video back to the beginning. It was right about here.
Not here.
Not
or here so much.
Or here so much, but right here.
These are all movie references that none of you are getting.
Well, the cool people, I hope you've seen
cool
Tommy
people.
Boy. That one's actually
that
funny.
Tommy Boy. Yeah. Earlier we did some Eddie Izzard.
Did we?
Chiropractor.
Oh, okay. Yeah, sure. That's not a movie, but that's one of his stand-ups, isn't it?
This is true.
Yeah.
This is true.
So, I think... Therefore, I am. But also, I get the impression that a lot of people back into spaces, not because they think they're cool. I think I'm cool. I don't back into spaces because I can't be bothered. Which is interesting because this is the same critique I have about people who do back into spaces. I think they back into spaces so they don't have to back out of them because it's hard.
That's why the pull-through is so great. But if you can back into a space...
You can back out of one. Yeah, seriously. It's like, oh, no.
I see that. I have great peripheral vision, people, and I see that.
Let the court record show that Mom is shaking her head no in disagreement.
Violently.
When you back into a space, nobody back there is moving. When you're backing out, everybody else is leaving, too.
I dig.
So it's easier to back into a space that's empty and
no one said that pet peeves were rational.
Logic has nothing to do with our peeping pets.
Logic has nothing to do with 23 hours of my day.
Okay, pet peeves or really anything else.
There's about an hour that I have some sanity and I'm like, okay.
Do you want to be part of the video again? What do you want?
I came back, I brushed my hair.
Yes. He's like, I'm all perfectly groomed now. Where's my clothes up? That's Jeremy, the blonde kitten that you saw earlier. Right about here. Are we on the last peeve here?
Yes,
yeah, we're on
yes.
the last one. Okay.
Oh, dear.
Must find my center. Find
the happy.
Must do another movie reference. Yep. Can you believe Ralph Macchio hasn't aged a day in, like, the last 20 years?
I know.
It's unfair.
Neither is Michael J. Fox.
Wow.
Ralph Macchio.
Or me. Well, in the last 20, yeah. I still look 15, right? Or 13. How old am I? 33.
How's Mom?
Yeah. Whoa. Mom hasn't changed a day in the last 20 years.
It's true. This is actually true.
Actually, I had a high school friend track me down on Facebook, and she said, congratulations on only aging 5 years since high school.
Wow. Yeah. Do I know who that was?
Jen Mello.
No.
I think you still have her cassette, her Meatloaf cassette, her CD.
That would be incorrect. I do not own CDs any longer.
Cassette? Because she said she loaned it to me. I said, you didn't loan it to me. You might have loaned it to my sister or my mom, but I don't have it.
No.
Hmm.
It could be in New York somewhere.
Okay.
I lost a lot of stuff there.
I told her I'd give her a buck and she can buy the album on iTunes or something. If she still really wants it. So, yeah. Interesting people and relationships you know nothing about unless... Hi, Jen. How are you doing?
I don't remember you and I'm sorry.
Yeah, well, she was my friend, not yours.
I was going to say. Oh, there's another.
Hi, Doris. Don't pull the plug. Thank you. That was close.
Yeah. That was close.
Yeah, okay. Final peeve.
See, but he found a center. This
yes,
is right.
Yes, I...
There it goes. Just like the hook.
Poetry.
You don't like Robert Frost or Shel Silverstein?
No, Shel Silverstein's awesome, and Robert Frost has his place.
Henry David Thoreau.
In the annals of history.
I don't think that's how it's pronounced.
That's how I pronounce it, because it makes me giggle because I'm immature. No, not so much poetry. I like poetry. I've written poetry, bad poetry. Poetry I may share with you one day.
You better put some comments and say... No need.
We don't need to see your... Just talk about Nintendo.
We're good.
Maybe if you wrote a poem.
You're doing fine without
Nintendo.
It.
Yeah, yeah, so... Poetry... that doesn't rhyme. If it doesn't rhyme... it's not a poem.
That is a lie.
You're right. That's completely false. I am wrong here. Poetry doesn't have to rhyme, but yes, it does. If it doesn't rhyme, it's not a poem. And I'm just going for a rhyme scheme here. You know, forget poetry that doesn't even have a meter. Yeah, it's how you can take your free verse and stuff it straight up your bum, Carolyn Goralchek. I remember you from high school, and your poetry was actually really fantastic, but it didn't have any meter, and it didn't rhyme, so it's not a poem. It was a structured paragraph, and it was really good, but it was not a poem.
Okay.
It has to rhyme!
Well, it's like, I don't like it when they force a rhyme. I can't even think of one right now, but when they're, like, often...
Chain and again.
Right,
do
there's
not
one.
Rhyme. Stop it.
No.
Because right. I hear hip hop artists actually trying to, you know, they're forcing the rhyme, and they're not even.
There's forced rhyme. That's what I don't.
They're not even mispronouncing the word. They're not. I've got a chain and I've got it again. They don't even do that. They're just chain and again. You're not even trying.
Yeah.
Poetry has to rhyme, or it's not poetry. In my little world.
Right.
If your poetry doesn't rhyme, I'm annoyed. Actually, if your poetry doesn't rhyme and you call it poetry, then I'm annoyed. If you say, hey, look at this structured paragraph, I'll say, oh, what a lovely structured paragraph.
Very insightful.
Yes. And here's another one.
That's four.
Yep, that's four.
That's Lucas.
That's Lucas.
Wait.
One of two gender-confused cats.
Piglet's on my bed. And then
Lucas, you actually saw in one of my videos from last year. It's called Lucille's Balls.
That's Lucas.
You can watch it by clicking right about here.
No, you can't. We've been lying to you this whole time.
I'll probably put that one up there just, you know, for the
plug
hits
yourself.
On that video.
Plug yourself. Yeah, so. Right, yeah. Kelly's not even spelled with a K. Yes, it is. Well, you'll never know.
Unless you rewind the video and look right about here. So, thank you all for tuning in. I would be surprised if you made it this far. If you made it this far, prove it.
By clicking here! I don't know how you're going to make that work, but you got to do something!
Congratulations, you clicked right here and paused the video. It's like, click.
It ends. It's
now
like,
what?
End the madness.
No. The secret word is rutabaga. Hit up the comments and prove you made it to the end of the video by saying rutabaga somewhere in your comment.
Or as Steve Martin calls it, rutabaga.
Rutabaga. Wow. My blue heaven.
As I said.
That's obscure.
Boom, baby.
It's a vegetable.
I don't get it.
Well, I don't want to eat it, so it's probably a vegetable. So. Toodaloo. Have fun. Merry Christmas and all the other holidays that are around this time of year. And stay tuned for more videos in the weeks to come. We're going to make another one pretty soon, which, actually, that means this one's definitely going to be first now. Yeah. I may put the other one first, and if I do that, then this is referring to the other one that you already watched, unless you're completely new to my channel, and then you haven't seen any of my other videos, and this isn't going to make any sense.
Which it probably didn't anyway.
That might be someone's pet peeve.
Boom. Meow.
Bye. All right. That was a disaster.
Totally. You're going to have a lot of fun editing that one. It'll take you long to edit it.
No. I just... That's organic. That flows. That's half an hour of goodness of gold.
That was great.
That's half an hour that needs to be edited down to about 10 minutes.